Wait a minute, let me put the camera on top. 30 seconds.
Yeah,
let's go. You can walk by me, you can walk by. Thank you.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Excuse me. Just pause there. In baptism, our brother Wayne Robert died with Christ and rose with him. Today we welcome him home in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Excuse me, please. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. We have come here today in grief and in sorrow to remember before God our brother Wayne Robert Phillips, Shacks, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be buried, and to comfort one another in our grief. We come as family and friends, in shock and in sorrow, to pray for him and to comfort one another. Let us pray. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that Wayne Robert and all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen. So we sing together our first hymn, How Great Thou Art.
God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. So, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Would you please sit for our scripture reading? Our reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, the 14th chapter, beginning at the first verse. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." We now have our eulogy, which will be given by Sammy Misra.
Pray. Fret not thyself because of the ungodly, neither be thou envious against the evildoers. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass and be withered even as the green herb. Put thou thy trust in the Lord and be doing good. Dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thou in the Lord, and he shall give thee thy heart's desire. He shall make thy righteousness as clear as the light, and thy just dealing as the noonday. Hold thee still in the Lord, and abide patiently upon him. But grieve not thyself at him whose way doth prosper against a man that doeth after evil counsels. Leave off from the wrath and let go displeasure. Fret not thyself, else shalt thou be moved to do evil. Wicked doers shall be rooted out, and that patiently abide the Lord Those that patiently abide the law, those shall inherit the land. Yet a little while, and the ungodly shall be clean gone. Thou shalt look after his place, and he shall be away. But the meek-spirited shall possess the earth, and shall be refreshed in the multitude of peace. The ungodly seeketh counsel against the just, and the gnasheth upon him with his teeth. The Lord shall laugh at him in his scorn, for he hath seen that his day is coming. The ungodly have drawn out the sword, and have bent their bow to cast down the poor and the needy, and to slay such as are of a right conversation. Their sword shall go through their own heart, and their bow shall be broken. A small thing that the righteous have is better than great riches of the ungodly. For the arms of the ungodly shall be broken, and the Lord upholdeth the righteous. The Lord knoweth the days of the godly, and their inheritance shall endure forever. They shall not be confounded in the perilous time, and in the days of the dearth they shall have enough. As for the ungodly, they shall perish, and the enemies of the Lord shall consume as the fats of the land. Yea, even as the smoke shall they consume away. The ungodly borroweth and payeth not again, but the righteous is merciful and liberal. Such as are blessed of God shall possess the land, and that they are cursed of him shall be rooted out. The Lord ordereth in good man's going and giving, and maketh his way acceptable to himself. Though he fall, he shall not be cast away, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. I have been young, and now I am old, and yet sore. And never the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging their bread. The righteous is ever merciful, and lendeth, and his seed is blessed. Flee from evil, and do the thing that is good, and dwell forevermore. For the Lord loveth the thing that is right. He forsaketh not his that be godly, but they are preserved forever and ever. The unrighteous shall be punished. As for the seed of the ungodly, it shall be rooted out. The righteous shall inherit the land and dwell therein forever. The mouth of the righteous is exercised in wisdom, and his tongue will be talking of wisdom and judgment. The law of his God is in his heart, and his going shall not slide. The ungodly seeth the righteous and seeketh the occasion to slay him. The Lord will not leave him in his hand, nor condemn him when he is judged. Hope thou in the Lord, keep his way, and he shall promote thee, that thou shalt possess the land. When the ungodly shall perish, thou shalt see that. I myself have seen the ungodly in great power, and flourishing like a green hay tree. I went by, and lo, he was gone. I sought him, but his place could do nowhere to be found. Keep innocency, and take heed unto the thing that is right, and for that shall bring a man peace at the last. As for the transgressors, they shall perish together, and the end of the ungodly is they shall be rooted out at the last. But the salvation of the righteous cometh of the Lord, who is also their strength in times of trouble. And the Lord shall stand by them and say them, he shall deliver them from the ungodly. and shall save them, because they put their trust in him. Amen. I was just thinking this morning of the early memories with me and my biggest brother, Wayne Phillips Shacks, my sisters Angela, Sonia, and Mumsy, of course. We all went to Beverton School. I was thinking back and talking to one of my other beloved brothers, Earl, One Knox, Gundy Grimes. One of my earliest memories was when the music teacher kicked me up my backside and I turned around to see Shacks and Earl laughing. All I could say about my brother today is one of the realest, honest, loyalist, humblest men that I ever met in my whole life. Imagine knowing a man for a whole lifetime and you never had one argument with him. Imagine one time I let him down and he still didn't argue and was upset with me. My heart goes out to the whole family today. I want to say more, but finding it very difficult. This is my first ever funeral. But the one thing that's definite, my boy, is that I loved you.
We sing now together the hymn, "The King of Love, My Shepherd Is."
Thank you.
only niece, his loved sister Angela's only child. So I'll be singing today in remembrance of him. So thank you all for just being here.
Let us pray. God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Wayne, for the grace and mercy he received from you, for all that was good in his life, for the memories we treasure today. You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant as we also remember him. Bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. And we pray for those who grieve and mourn, for all who remember Shacks and all who give thanks for his life, that they may carry on his example of kindness,
generosity and love. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on all who mourn. Give them patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. And we join all our prayers together in the words of the Lord's Prayer as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We now have a tribute from Jason.
My deepest sympathies to the family, to Phillips' family. It brings me great sadness to have to be standing here today, talking to you all about Shax, because I still find it hard to believe that he's gone. I don't have all the words to describe the loss and emptiness that Shax's death has left in all our lives. I used to speak to this guy almost every day, so for him to be snatched from us so suddenly is deeply traumatic. I'm absolutely gutted by the senseless and devastating loss that has impacted the Grove community and the Phillips family. Many of us here today have grown up with Shax in our lives, so to not have him with us any longer is very difficult to deal with. Shax was a giant in stature and personality. He always had time to listen to your story, even though he'd probably chuckle through it. He was always there for good times and bad. But don't get me wrong, Shax had his moody moments. He had a hard head. But he had a certain charm and warmth about him that made it almost impossible not to like him. He was always dressed dapper and loved to party hard. Everyone who knew him knew he could grace the dance floor with his unique moves, and he always managed to shock out, but not knock out anyone who was close by. We all miss him every day, and I wish I wasn't here talking to speak to you about him right now, like this. So let's help and support each other through this grief, immense sadness and pain. And let's hold on to the precious memories we have of Shax and remember him this way so he can be in our hearts and thoughts always. Son, brother, father, uncle, partner, brethren, Shax.
Andrew will now perform Amazing Grace.
He is found. blind, but now he sees. Amen.
We now have our family tributes.
Good morning. I'm Wayne's younger sister, Sonia. Just a few words. Wayne, since you've passed away, life just hasn't been the same. The time we spent together meant the world to me. I have so many treasured memories as we grew up together. I'm so grateful for the years we've had and the closest that we shared. Your thoughtfulness and your loyalty and the way you always cared. You brought joy and happiness into my life. You are such a wonderful brother. You mean so much to me, and you're irreplaceable. And you will be dearly missed. Rest in eternal peace, Wayne. You're with Dad now. I love you, and I'll mourn you until I join you. Baby sis.
Hello everyone, who doesn't know, I'm Lisa, Wayne's partner. Just something short to say. As we gather here today, still reeling from Wayne's tragic death, we are shocked, scared and angered at the unfairness and the senselessness that took him from us. And seeking to make sense of this, well-meaning people will tell us that this is all part of God's plan, or that it's his time, or he's in a better place. But we cry out, while God certainly knows his plan, we do not. Wayne may indeed be in a better place now, but we want him here with us. Unfortunately, there are no easy answers, as difficult and as painful as it is. We acknowledge the importance of Wayne's life. Wayne and myself did not get nearly enough time together. But as heartbroken as I am grateful to have had every minute we had together. And the pleasure of this beautiful man in my life. I am grateful for the happiness we shared together, and this will last a lifetime. I will mourn the loss of my darling, my soulmate, my everything, my world. But I will find comfort in the knowledge that he loved me to no end. I will miss Wayne until the day that God calls me. He has left me a love that cannot be broken until we come together again. I am not complete. It is no longer Wayne and Lisa anymore. It's me awaiting my turn. Thank you for being you, darling. Everyone here knows that he was the greatest man on earth. It only took meeting him once to remember him forever. The biggest smile and the warmest heart, the caring nature that he has, he will always be my love. And there will always be a hole in my heart that will never heal. He was my soulmate, plain and simple. It takes some people decades to find the person that they are meant to be with. As Wayne used to tell me, Some people search for what we have for their whole lifetime, but I never find it. But what we have is real. We found it in each other. As we lay our Wayne to rest today, we bury only his body, his spirit, his soul, and his amazing ability to make us smile lives on. It lives on in the stories that people are sharing and how he touched so many people's lives. The love can be seen in the eyes of his family and friends. They will never be the same, but the world is better for the years that my beloved Wayne has lived. Thank you, everyone.
We sing together now our next hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. To the mercy of God, our Maker and God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Wayne to your mercy. In the name of Jesus the Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and the glory of thy people Israel. May holy angels bear you away to paradise, and there at the threshold may saints and martyrs welcome you and bear you home to the heavenly city, Jerusalem. Would you please sit down? We come now to the time for the viewing, and I'll ask the funeral directors to prepare Wayne for you to pay your final respects.
speaking. Is that what? Is everyone to view?
Yeah.
So, okay.
Don't move. Guys, don't move, please. I just want to get that shot with you guys. One moment. I want a shot. Four bearers, either side, please. Thank
Same
you.
Format you came in.
Over, I will fly.
end, and we are due to restart at about 1:30 at the grave. So we're now coming to an end, and the live stream will finish, and it will restart at the grave. Thank you very much.